do want to offer our love to Paul Spack from Dover. He just lost his wife, Joanne, and I'll be at St. Joseph's in Dover on 1 o'clock on Tuesday, right, Paul? And we met in marriage and counseling back in the 1970s. And that's right. We both haven't changed. It's marvelous. So welcome to St. Catherine Drexel, and we'll be praying for Joanne. Sure will. Now, this is a jar. What's inside? Not fireflies. Ashes. Yes, ashes. And we got plenty more in the back sacristy. Ash Wednesday begins, and I was telling the kids at the 8:30, Cinderella. Cinderella. Cinderella, a beautiful young girl. Beautiful. But the name, Ella, in Latin is girl. Puella is boy. Ella, the girl who sits in the cinders. The girl who sits in the ashes. And, you know, you're all beautiful, but Father Dick and I are going to smudge you with this on Ash Wednesday. And it's the traditional sign from the Bible, beginning with the Hebrew Scriptures, for repentance. To repent, to turn around. Repentance means to turn around and go the other way. It means to change your mind, change the way of thinking. It's conversion, transformation. It's an outer sign of what's happening inside you. Just to let you know, Ash Wednesday, we have Mass here at St. Catherine's at 8 o'clock in the morning and 5:30 in the early evening. And there's a 12 o'clock Mass at the Huggins Hospital Chapel. All right, so if you can possibly make it, begin the journey with the risen Christ. The only Christ we have, the only Christ there is the risen Christ. And we journey with him for 40 days of Lent, as he spent 40 days in the desert, so we spend 40 days in intimacy with him. And what I want to throw out today is don't wait until Wednesday to prepare for this. Start praying now. Start talking to him now. And Matthew Kelly says, don't say, well, this is what I want to do. Jesus, no. You ask him, Jesus, what do you want me to do? What do you want me to do? And you'll know. You will know if you spend time in intimate prayer with Jesus Christ, you will know what he wants you to do with him during Lent. And Matthew Kelly will say, I think it's great advice, instead of 10 things, he'll say, just take one thing. What's the one thing that Jesus wants me to do with him during Lent so that I will grow? That I will change, that I will be transformed. What's the one thing? And I want you to get rid of this terrible idea of perfection. It's an awful idea. It's a mathematical concept. It does not exist in Judaism or Christianity. You could say that only God is perfect. We're human. We're not perfect. We're human. Later on this year, Mother Teresa is going to be canonized, right? To be Saint Mother Teresa. And most of us have known her. I met her with 15,000 other people, but I did see her. And what a thrill it was to see this little woman, the saint, come into the room. Just extraordinary. But when someone's being canonized, you know, they have a devil's advocate. Did you know that? And the devil's advocate is supposed to interview people to find out why this person shouldn't be canonized. Okay? And what I want to tell you is, I haven't read what they found, but I can guarantee you that the sisters who lived with Mother Teresa and worked with her, the doctors and nurses who knew her so well, taking care of the dying and the sick, I'm sure they're going to say to the devil's advocate, well, you know, one day she really lost it. One day she really blew her top. Of course she did. She's human. She's not perfect. She's human. And so we have our good days and we have our bad days. And keep that in mind. She is going to be canonized, and because she's human, not perfect, but human. We're all made of the same stuff. Let's look at the two apostles in the Gospels, in the Scriptures. St. Paul, this genius, this mystic, the first Christian theologian, he persecuted the early Christians. He arrested them. He was trying to squelch this following of this carpenter from Nazareth. And he says of himself, he says, I am the least of the apostles. I'm not worthy of the name apostle. This is St. Paul. See, the closer you get to Christ, the light of Christ, it doesn't lead to pride. It leads to humility and honesty. Honesty and humility. Those are the signs of holiness. Humility and honesty. St. Paul, I'm the least of the apostles. I'm not worthy of the name. Look at Peter. When Peter sees this miraculous catch of fish, he sees the power of God, the glory of God shining through Jesus. Peter says, leave me, Lord. I'm a sinful man. In the light of Christ, Peter is honest and humble. So if you know a humble person, that means they're close to God. A proud person is not close to God. Not. Leave me, Lord, I'm a sinful man. Lord, I'm not worthy of the name apostle. Both of them demonstrate what it's like to encounter Christ. One was a positive experience. Peter witnessed this great miracle. Paul got knocked down by the risen Christ on his way to Damascus to persecute. A negative experience, if you want. But both encountered Christ. It was a turning point. A turning point in your life. And we all have different turning points. We all do. Some can be positive experiences when we're touched by God. Some can be negative experiences. Someone stopped for DWI. That's a negative experience. But maybe it's a turning point in a person's life. It's so important that you talk to Jesus. Say, what do you want? What's the one thing you want me to do this Lent? At the 8:30 Mass with little kids, I said, well, you know, clean your room and do things without your mom and your daddy telling you. But for us adults, what does he want? It could be, if someone's a smoker, stop smoking. We know that that's medically bad for us. Maybe Jesus wants us to stop that and take care of our health. Maybe he wants someone to stop drinking so much, to just give it up for Lent. These different addictions. Does anybody know what the fastest growing addiction is in the United States and in the world? Anybody know? Pornography. I'm telling you. It's through the internet. It's through the internet that this is happening. And so be aware of that. Be aware. Don't get caught in this addiction of pornography. I do not have a computer at my house. There's one in the office. But I do not have a computer at 50 Friar Tuck. You know why? Because I live alone. And I, like St. Paul and St. Peter, I'm a weak human being. And I'm not going to put myself in that position. I'm just telling you that. That's how I handle it. Be careful. What is it that Jesus wants you to change during these 40 days of Lent? There's one thing, Master Kelly says, and you'll be a new person next year. I think we'll be a new person by Easter. A couple of suggestions, a couple of things. On the website, check our parish website, Matthew Kelly has the best Lent you ever had. It's free. You can just log in, and every day you will have a little meditation, a little video. And, you know, we've given you three books by Matthew, Rediscovering Catholicism, The Joy of the Gospel, and this Christmas, Rediscovering Jesus. And these meditations for Lent, for the 40 days of Lent, are based on rediscovering Jesus. I suggest that for us adults. Wouldn't that be great? If you have a computer, instead of pornography, this is what we got to have. This is what we got to have. Matthew Kelly. So sign in, log in for that. The 8:30 Mass took all of the rice bowls. They're all gone. But I suggest that. Alone or as a family, once a week, you have a simple meal. Maybe macaroni and cheese. You pray before you eat. You thank God for this simple meal, knowing that there are people in New Hampshire who are going hungry. Food pantries are busier than ever. So you thank God for the food. You have a simple meal. And then at the end of Lent, the money that you save is an envelope. You send it in to help feed the hungry. It's all there. Prayer, works of mercy, and fasting. Prayer, works of mercy, and fasting. That's the tradition of Lent. But you're going to find out as you go through it, it's a struggle. And you're going to find out where you're strong and where you're weak. We're both. We're human. We're not perfect. You're going to discover your strengths and your weaknesses, and that's good information to have. Know yourself. And when you try to follow Jesus in the desert of Lent, you're going to get to know yourself. I just throw out two more ideas. Every Friday, we have the Stations of the Cross. This Friday, our high school parishioners are going to be leading us, reading each of the stations. I suggest that it's from St. Francis of Assisi himself, this beautiful meditation, walking with Jesus the way of the cross, ending up now at the resurrection, at the tabernacle. I will be here every Friday at 6 o'clock. From 6 to 7 to hear confession. And I want to tell you something. This guy right here, this is one of the best confessors. He'll spend, you know, I'll like 2 minutes. He'll spend 10 to 15 minutes. Really. He's an excellent, excellent confessor. And don't go to confession to a perfect priest. You got me? I'm telling you. I would go to St. Peter or St. Paul any day of the week, because they faith and they receive God's mercy. And I think I can speak for you and for myself. We're not perfect, but you can tell us anything. And I'm just saying, he's a marvelous confessor. Go to confession during Lent. I'll be around. Catch us when you can. But every Friday before the stations, I'll be here. Finally, the ladies of St. Catherine Vesper are sponsoring a Lenten day of prayer the last Saturday of this month, February 27th. There's an insert in the bulletin. There's a Holy Franciscan priest going to be here for that. Consider, for men and women, for teenagers, consider coming to the Lenten day of prayer. And registrations of forms are under Father Ham's portrait. So it's a joyful season of Lent. And I'm working on my plans with Jesus. You do the same. Wait and see. We're gonna be resurrected people. We're gonna be new people once Easter comes. Well, please stand now.